Well, you can probably just about see me in the darkness of the Oval. England have won the Ashes, a fantastic performance today. Australia batted superbly, really made England work for it. But in the end, it was too much to bat out on this just really dusty, dry pitch that was breaking up. And in the end, it was Graham Swan who spun and took the wicket, took Mike Hussey's edge off the pad into Alistair Cook's hand, and the full house under the sun-drenched, baked outfield went absolutely crazy. A fantastic day for England.
Pretty special. I mean, so many emotions we went through today. Hope, kind of frustration, worry, despair at times when we didn't look like we were going to take a wicket. And then to come through and to finish it off until you actually get over the line, you don't realise how hard it is to get over that line. It's an amazing day. It's one that, seemed a long way off after Headingley, if I'm honest. But all credit to the guys, because they had to dig very, very deep. And an Ashes series forces a player to dig very, very deep. And the guys have done that, and they've come out fighting. And, it's a special moment for all of us. The ball was old. It didn't look like it was doing much for anyone. Ponting and Hussey were playing exceptionally well. And we needed a moment of inspiration, and we weren't quite sure where it was going to come from, but you can't keep Fred out of the game, and that was an unbelievable bit of fielding, which just set us in motion again. And that's the value of being a great all-rounder, is that you can do it in so many different ways, whether it's with the bat or the ball or a great catch or, in this instance, a fantastic run-out. I think for me personally, I suppose it is because I've captained the side, but... we've moved forward from 2005. They're very different personalities involved, different management team as well. And any time you win an Ashes series, it's an unbelievably special moment for all of us. We've got a young side, and we can get a lot better than where we are at the moment. So, we're still pretty inconsistent, as we've ably demonstrated this series. We've shown some guts and determination, some character, and Stuart Broad to come back after a tough first two test matches and bowl as well as he's done and bat and contribute. That says a lot for his character. The way Jonathan Trott came into this game, you look at it and it astounds you, really. Probably the biggest game in all our careers. And when you add to that that you're making your debut, you don't know what test cricket's like at all. And to go out and play with as much composure as he did says a huge amount about his character as well. So that's greatly encouraging for us. But everyone over the course of the series has had to stand up. That's the reality. In a Ashes series, there's nowhere to hide. If you've got any weaknesses, they'll be exploited. You've got to deal with a lot of off-field stuff as well. And the guys have done that, and we've come through. It feels pretty special to be standing here now. It's been it seems like a lot more than 7 or 8 months ago when I took over. I mean, so much water under the bridge. We're in a pretty bad state, to be honest with you. So it says a huge amount for what Andy Flower's done. I mean, you guys probably don't see a lot of the work he does, but the way he communicates with the players and drives us, and he's trying to take us to a different place to where we've been before, and it's fantastic to be able to work with him. Hopefully we've got a long way to go in that respect as well.
I think it's a bit what Andrew said, Strauss said up on stage as well. I think that both teams, when they played particularly well, were very good, but when they played poorly, both teams were very, very bad. I think that's certainly what's happened with us. When we've tended to lose a session through this series, it was like the one the other day where we lose 8 wickets and completely blow ourselves out of the water and all the pressure comes back on us then. So I think that's really what's happened on a couple of occasions through this series. If you look back to not being able to get the final couple of wickets at Cardiff, and then our first innings batting at Lords, we lost late wickets there, our first innings batting here. We've had opportunities in the series. We thought that 330 out there on that wicket, the way it played on the first day, we had to at least match that in the first innings or get past that. But we were 170 short. So You know, it was always going to be hard work for us from there in this game. So I think that's, you know, that's the difference, I think, in the whole series is when we've been very good, as we were in Cardiff and as we were in Leeds, we were exceptional. But when we were poor, we were very, very poor. So we need to become more consistent. Now, performances across the board need to become more consistent if we want to win big series like this one. No, I don't think you can probably get any more disappointed than I am right now. But looking back to 2005, I guess I was feeling exactly the same then. You know, we'd all spoken about it and built the series up so much, and we all spoke about how much it meant to us to be a part of the series and to play well in the series and hopefully be good enough at the end of the day to win the series. But we've come up short. So, yeah, look, I'm obviously hurting and the rest of the guys in the dressing room are hurting as well. You know, we were in really good shape coming into this game, and you know, I thought we hung in there really well on the first day to restrict them the way we did on day one. But as you're looking back on everything that's been said through the course of this game, Ian Bell was probably right when he said that it felt like a day three pitch on the first day, and that's probably spot on.
After Headingley, it was all doom and gloom, and I suppose it's like anything. When you're good, you're great, and when you're bad, you're awful. And I think it shows that there's a lot of character in English cricket. I think it shows that English sportsmen can rise to the occasion and do the job. And that's a special moment for us. And I suppose in 2005 we took some heart from how the rugby team had done in 2003. And the more that English sports teams can win, it can almost be sort of self-perpetuating, can make you more and more confident going forward.
Okay,
I think there'll be a nice, quiet, muted celebration somewhere.